there is a conservative that is so very concerned, so very, very concerned about the conservative movement. And he happens to be the lone voice in the wilderness over at MSNBC, Joe Scarborough.
Mm-hmm.
The station that has most of their hosts, with the exception of Essie Cobb, having full-fledged orgasms on air every time the president gives a speech. The station hosts that just met with President Obama at the White House for a council with him on how to handle the PR. Your hosts of your news shows are going to meet with the president about PR. Wow. A station with an avowed socialist on the air every night that threatened to fight Mitt Romney's son. The station that openly pines for Obama. Joe, who's on that station, was so concerned about the state of things that he's just said this.
Bully. You punch him in the face. Do you think any of these people on talk radio, if they're punched in the face by a Republican nominee, do you think they would push back? No, they're cowards. They're bullies. Punch them in the face, and they back off. Bullies do that. Mitt Romney, and we said it nonstop. For 2 years, he would never stand up to these bullies. So they framed his campaign, and he got his tail
whipped. How many sister soldier moments did he have?
Oh, my God.
Six, seven,
thousands.
Eight.
Thousands.
Yeah.
Thousands. And we started saying this, Mika, in 2010, when Glenn Beck said the president was a racist who hates all white people. We said, this is your sister soldier moment. And what did he do?
We wanted to see more in him many, many times, and he did nothing. He did nothing in terms of showing a real sense of moral conviction, a sense of what is right and what is wrong, what makes sense and what doesn't make sense. He couldn't do it. He was always thinking about what would happen if I did that.
It's worth pointing out, too, that the most prominent voices in conservative radio came out and trashed Bill Kristol after he came out with that quote. Just
that's fine.
Fill in the blanks of the story. They came out immediately, said he's waving the white flag of surrender. He's been a liberal his whole life.
Oh, shut up.
Et cetera, et cetera.
Okay. Bill Kristol deserves to be trashed on just about everything he said because he's so colossally wrong. But first of all, Joe, you might want to read up on Marxism. So maybe you can recognize Marxist policies when you see and hear them from your friends and coworkers. Class warfare, redistribution of wealth. It may sound familiar. You might also recognize somebody getting punched in the face and not sitting down. Still standing up to the bully on the street. I know, because I've stood up for a very long time to the bullies. Mainly people like you. And the people of MSNBC, because I think you just tried to punch me in the face again. I don't really care. But secondly, if you're worried that Mitt wouldn't stand up to me, if by not standing up, Joe, you mean by never appearing on my show once, ever during the campaign, not ever during the campaign, not on the radio, not on television, not on the website, nowhere. Zero contact with Mitt Romney. Zero. If by not standing up to me, you mean, you know, by not taking our advice on anything, ever, you have that exactly right. You have that exactly right. And I realize you're a tough guy, Joe, you know, that wants to punch somebody in the face. It seems that you are in a very hostile work environment there. A lot of the people over at MSNBC want to punch people in the face. But I'm a lover, Joe, not a fighter. My friend, however, Pat, has made the offer that you can punch him in the face anytime. Anytime you'd like and just see what happens.
See what happens.
It'd be fine.
Yeah.
So let's get this straight. Joe Scarborough is on MSNBC for a reason. And here it is. He's not a conservative. I don't know what he is. I don't care. I really don't care. But I'm really sick of these Republicans. You know what? I think that's what he is. He's a Republican. And I'm really sick of these Republicans who are just progressive Republicans who try to talk down to everybody and tell us how smart they are and how everybody else is just so stupid. That's great. You can have your silly opinion there, Joe. You can have it. I don't speak for the Republicans. I don't want to speak for the Republicans. I speak for me. I tell you how I feel. I don't want to speak for the Republicans. I wish the Republicans would stop speaking, quite honestly. But tough guy Joe, he talks about bullies in talk radio. I'd like to know who these bullies are. I mean, who? How? How are we being bullies? We had no contact with Mitt Romney. Here's Joe considered talk radio hosts bullies because when he got into talk radio, he got his teeth kicked in because this is actually a hard job. But he got his teeth kicked in and he got bullied right out of the medium and wound up in progressive TV land where, because see, people in talk radio, they can see through frauds that fast. That's why you either succeed or you fail in talk radio so fast. Because this is the hardest. Look, I do every medium. I do. The only thing I don't do, I don't do horse whispering and smoke signals. But I think we, I also don't do Morse code. But I believe we are in every possible medium available. This is the hardest one. Because you're without a rope. Without a net. You got nothing but rope, and you can hang yourself every single day. And Joe Scarborough did a very nice job. We don't need a hangman for Joe Scarborough. He makes the nooses himself every single day. Joe, you shouldn't make nooses. You keep hanging yourself. He gets his teeth kicked in. He winds up selling his soul for a mess of pottage and cavorting around with the enemy, that he becomes the enemy. Joe, good for you. You made your bed. And you're lying in it, and it's wonderful. And I know you feel the same way about me. Beck, you made your bed, and you're lying. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. And I'm thrilled with the bed that I am. I'm thrilled with it. But you keep leaning forward, or whatever Marxist theme your propagandists have worked out with the president. You keep moving forward. We'll just keep standing straight as Americans who believe in the Constitution and your right to have a different opinion